Hi guys, I'm Anudio Tieno and welcome to TMS. So today we have special guests, obviously. We know them as, you know, the pace setters, the event planners, you know, they make waves and stuff. But anyways, we have bachelors today and we're going to, you know, get some insights about them, you know, have some juicy gist. And we're going to play a game after, so you guys should stay tuned. Make sure you guys subscribe, like and share. Thank you. Hi guys.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
I had fun, it was amazing. Is that true?
It was fun.
Your face was all over the place, so why not?
Stop it, Joe. My mother's going to sit.
You can't start
there, like.
I don't say anything.
Okay.
Don't book me.
Let's be serious. So, AJ, you're the CEO, right, of Bachelors? And I wanted to know if you're the founder of Bachelors too.
Yes.
You were? So, why did you start Bachelors?
I wanted something clean, you know, fine boys, see them, they fine boys.
There's a girl.
They hate us.
Something that's, you know, that's clean, pretty much, yeah. Just fine guys, putting up a nice, good show every time we come out, people appreciate us and stuff.
Okay, so it's Bachelors, but we have a lady, skin sad lady.
That's
right. The thing is, she works for us. You know, so these are the original bachelors.
Okay.
So she's part of the team, but she works, you know, with the team.
So was that an incentive to bring her to the group, or it's just...
Yeah, you know.
I'm awesome.
Because you need someone to, you know, to cool things down every now and then. You need a female to say, guys, it's okay. You know,
we want to make those special calls.
Yeah.
So one guy, like, being amongst all these men, do you ever feel intimidated or like...
Nope, not one bit.
And the cultural difference, is that like a problem or...
No, I just get lost when they start making pigeon jokes. I'm not laughing. Most of the time, they're like, huh? But other than that, we're good.
Okay. So, are you guys all single or is a married man?
Is married?
It's a married man. Okay.
He's really married man, yeah.
Okay, bachelor. How has this been in, like, I don't want to get too personal, but like, has it really affected your personal life being, like, you know, out there all the time, having to go to parties like every other weekend or like?
Not really, because my girlfriend, she understands the business. She knows what I'm into, because I was part of the team even before we met. So she knew what she was getting herself into, and we have that understanding, you know. And yeah, it has not affected my personal life in any way. She understands me. We understand ourselves.
Girls.
Okay, so what about school? Like, while you guys were in school, I think you guys are all old now, but like, while you guys were in school, how did you manage to, like, you know, keep it straight?
It was hard, though. It was very hard. But we had to work hard, you know. I had to make sure that it doesn't get in between, like, school.
So,
although,
like,
I had to make some sacrifices along the way, but, you know.
So which one was your priority?
Sometimes I actually prioritize bachelor's events. A lot of the time. So, like, you know, but then again, like, I wasn't so, my mindset wasn't like school. I wanted to connect while I was in school, you know, try and make a difference somewhere outside of school in a way. So I wasn't all like, oh, get 80s, get 90s. So it was more like, just pass, do well, and then, you know, make sure, like, the events are also, you know, good.
Okay, I wanted to ask about, like, you guys had, what's his name, the comedian?
Basket Mouth
and Bobby.
Yeah.
So how did you guys bring them here? Like, did you have to talk to, who did you guys have to talk to? It was like a kind of that group thing at the
That's confidential.
You can't be exposing
our
contact.
To air our details out here.
I tell you, then everybody else is going to know. Everybody else is going to start doing it.
So it's confidential.
But let me answer that question. We just have the right connections. Like, we know who to talk to when we want to bring in someone. So,
yeah.
So like we just know where to go. And
so have you guys had a problem like down the line trying to bring somebody you couldn't bring, or like that's confidential too?
There are always issues, but you know, we just know the right buttons.
Yeah, so now we're constantly working and trying to bring, you know, the best comedians or musicians from Nigeria. It's very, very hard. It's harder than it seems.
Yeah. Why just Nigeria?
Because we cater to the, you know, the African crowd. Mostly West African crowd. Yeah.
African, and not Nigerian.
Most of us are connected to Nigerians. So, you know, we'll take care of our own first.
Do you have a problem with that?
No.
She has no artist, no musician for her country. That's not true.
Zimbabwe is not, we're not as popular. We're not out there.
Where are you from? Zimbabwe.
So our music scene is not as big.
Doesn't exist.
It exists.
Abracadabra.
Exactly.
I said there's a song like that. After I'm showing you the song, you would die. It's a nice song, bro, but like, it took them 20, 50 years to come up with one good song.
If you bring one of our artists, like, we are done.
Yeah, we're done. That's, we just pack our load and close business.
Go back home.
So how do you guys raise money? Like, do you guys have sponsors or you take it from your pocket?
All us.
We have investors.
We do have.
That's also
tough. Why did you laugh?
I laughed at because, you know,
it's hard.
Yeah. Okay, so you take it from your pocket and you have investors,
yes.
Too,
right.
Yes.
And that has been a problem.
Money is always a problem one way or the other, but like we always make sure, you know, at the end, you know, everything turns out well.
Okay, so, yeah. So when you guys have misunderstandings about like events, like who gets the offer, say, is it you or is it just a good? Because you guys
see,
are four, and there's no like.
Oh, yeah, it's 50-50. Mm.
We do have misunderstandings, but it always works out in a way. Like, I don't think there's been any point where we have to, like, where two people were at loggerheads, where we have to choose between one side or the other. Like, at the end of the day, we're always like, there's always like a voice of reason going on, and we all just come to the same conclusion at the end of the day. So there hasn't really been a point where we have to be like, is it that my way or the highway, or these people are choosing this and we are choosing that. So at the end of the day, we just all have to.
It works as a team, right? So I decide sometimes when we can't move forward, I just say, guys, we're going to take blue. I don't give a shit. Mm-hmm. So then everybody else is going to take blue, then we work in it, and most of the time it works.
Okay. So do you guys do anything personally? Like, do you guys have your personal things, or just bachelors all the way?
We all sort of have
Dr.
a personality.
Dr. Momo!
I start from there.
Well, that's my career. It's not like a personal, like, business thing. It's just my career. Like,
are a doctor.
No. I aspire to be one, so I want to be a doctor at some point. So that's why everyone... But that's my Twitter handle, so everyone just calls me doctor. So I'm into, like, that's my career. So apart from the bachelor's entertainment,
medicine. Oh, interesting.
What about you, AJ?
Me, I do everything. MC Styles. I do everything. I'm a hustler. But yeah, maybe next year or so you start seeing, you know, more from me business wise. Because now I'm just laying down the foundations.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. One guy.
I'm the only student in the group still in school.
Well, like me, I'm a hustler too. Okay, not like him, but like I'm into fashion. So I own a fashion blog, renifresh.com. So once in a while,
check it out, guys.
Once in a while, I look fly, you know, put one or two things together. I put one or two things together, you know, like let me be serious. So I try to, you know, put looks together. And then I tell people, because people always ask me, where do you get this, where do you get that? So I kind of started a blog, so I'll be able to, like, you know, tell people where I got it from, how they can put it together, and stuff like that.
Do you want to make money out of it, or it's just...
Yeah, for now, I'm trying to build a platform, right? Trying to get a name out, so, like, when they say Renifresh, people know who it is. And then I have ideas for, like, clothing line, you know, to style people, everything, like, so... First of all, I want to start with, like, you know, getting the name, the platform out, and then later on can branch out into other
things. Blue.
You know?
Okay, so where do you guys see yourselves in 3 years? Do you think you still be a group or it's on your own?
How long is the teaching in
education?
This
is the
second year. Second year.
Second year.
We already passed the second year. We're in the third year.
This is the second year.
Yeah?
We're doing the third Pisces.
Yeah, but the first Pisces was our first event.
First
so it's not really
year.
Like, we have not been in business by that time.
I guess.
First Pisces to the second Pisces, that's
1 year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Second
Pisces
is the second year.
I don't want to agree. I feel like we started when we started planning Pisces.
Yeah.
Like, January-ish, yeah. So like,
even
I feel like
still, it's not exactly
it's not
3 years.
Oh, okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
can
okay,
win.
Okay,
you
okay,
win.
Two
you
years,
win.
Two years.
In 3 years.
I think the company is going to last for 8 years. I'm just being honest. By then, everyone's going to be married.
Oh,
he's thinking ahead.
So you ought to marry.
Of course not.
Eventually.
What?
Eventually.
You can't be a 40-year-old single man.
Like then, if we're still, you know, if everything is still good, we probably reform the word, rebuild the company, and you know maybe start doing something else.
Yeah, branch into something.
Definitely
bigger.
Something bigger than what we're doing now.
So, did you guys start initially for there was
Obina.
We started
Bino.
Four, but then
we started as four guys, and he left for you know some personal reasons, but he's still part of the family. He's always welcome whenever he's, you know, he comes to all our parties, shows. Yeah, so we're good still.
Mm.
He just doesn't, you know, work with us as much.
So, the reason why you three are single, does it have to do with bachelors? Like, has bachelors affected?
What kind of question is that?
Affected,
I think our son is always ready to get married.
Yeah, like, we're waiting to be, you know,
we're following his footsteps.
That's
not
the question.
Can't you see we're trying to divert the question?
No, that's
okay, AJ, you go first.
Me, I have to know my girlfriend for like 5 years before we get married. So
you know,
she's single, no, not married.
Why don't you
marry? Why don't you have a girlfriend?
Exactly.
Now?
So
because the team of the team.
That's one. It's going to be very hard for me to find a girl because.
Or to be a baby boy.
Yeah. Not that.
But to drink God.
See, a lot of times, they just assume that,
you're
part of the bachelors. No, this guy's a bad guy.
So, bachelors are affecting your single life?
I'm a good guy, to be honest, but like, right now I'm not even focused on relationships and stuff. But I'm looking for the right, you know, spectacle.
So, woman is a spectacle.
The perfect flower.
Wow.
And then, from
they'll say you're objectifying them.
We'll not date for 5 years. Then, I'll not think, maybe.
So that's not my own reason.
Yeah.
My own reason is like the bachelor is not affecting me anyway. It's just personal, like personal.
It's too sensitive.
Life. No. It's just my personal life. I've been in relationships in the past, so I need time to, you know, rearrange myself before I get into a new relationship. So
the bachelors have not affected my life in that sense. I just want to be single, and if the right person comes along, then. Uncle, what are you talking about? You guys have to say?
Without those, you're suitors.
Okay. Sorry,
yo. Pessy cannot play with her again.
Okay. If you guys were amongst like people trying to do something with their lives, like just here, what would you tell them? Just like at the spot, like just.
I understand. Like people trying to
do something basically, like maybe.
Like start a business?
Yes. Start a business or like be in a group or.
For me, I would say you should like have the right like, because it's a business. You need people, you need customers, you need like people to patronize you. So you need like the right system in place, you need the right team, you need a team with like this connection. So I think the most important thing is having the right team in place, like your startup team. That from there, that's when you can know how far you need to go. So I would tend to get the right team in place, the right foundation essentially. You know, and capital as well, that's what they do very important.
Money.
So, that's what I was telling them.
So, AJ, how did you know to trust them? Like, because you're starting a group, you can't just keep random people.
I can't get rid of Rennie, trying. So I've known Rennie for the longest time. Went to the same high school back in Nigeria. I used to bully him back in the day. I still bully him now. But like, he's my brother. Like, you know, I don't think there's anything that can separate both of us. And then there was one time I went to a party in Hamilton. I saw this man. Telling everybody, yo, move to the right, move to the right. Everything was so well organized. And I'm like, yo, I need alcohol. Go and ask Hassan. You know, how can I get some water? Ask Hassan. Yeah. And he was so composed. And I'm just like, yo, bro.
how do you do this, man?
So I took his number, and then from then I just started watching the guy. Asked a few questions about him, and then I think we went to the same high school as well,
Nigeria. Yeah.
But I didn't know him then, he was a Juma. But yeah, so I'm like, yo, the connection is there. I spoke to him, very humble guy. Everything was just very easy from his side. So I'm like, yeah, I'd like you to be part of the team. But these guys are already professionals. They already know how to do the job. So
it was easier.
Yeah, exactly. It's very easy. So yeah, that's how it started.
So what about DJs? Like, how did you guys handle that?
At first, we wanted to do like the whole management thing, because the bachelor's is a learning process. We're still learning, really. I don't think we're there yet. We wanted to do the whole management thing, like, you know, get the management commission, and then put them out there, help them get bigger and everything. But the market here is not big enough. The DJs are not making enough money, so we decided to just, you know, let them. Keep everything, like the respondents, that's the word, yeah. So we still try to promote them, put them out there. Like, all we ask is their loyalty, and when it comes to our events, that they give their best. That's it.
Okay, so any last words before we...
We dying. Any last words? What's your idea?
Okay, I don't know, thoughts.
Any last words? Are you about to shoot us?
The team is actually, we're actually bigger now, because we have John Green. He does the old picture thing. He's into visuals.
Mm-hmm. That puts me on
Facebook. Yes, so we have John Green, and we have two other promoters, Isosa and Lucky. So they just help us, you know, make sure the show is well put together.
Don't forget the DJs.
So the DJs, Cashmere, DJ Kanzi, and DJ Javier. Two of them are just, you know, really good guys.
Well, listen, yeah. One, twos, and two.
They're all part of the team. And that's what makes the batch of us.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you guys for being on TMS. We'll soon start the game and get ready for some.
They are refreshments.
Oh, the game's refreshments.
Sorry.
So, have any of you had a question from Gary before?
Wow! I did not see that one coming.